We had a lesson on unusual connections, strange things, odd places, getting into an island. Okay, the connection that we went over were two-handed. Leads right hand and follows left hand, and left to left. These ones get in progressive order of oddness and funky.
Strangeness.
Yeah. Our goal here was to introduce a couple of moves so that we could get everyone more comfortable with interacting within this framework. And so the moves that we went over were two-handed. It
cut turns.
Notice how much our bodies are each broken.
Yeah, we're setting up this turn.
Just set up with the big rotation.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it's much harder.
And then what's
it? The human did was the pass on the arm.
And then we end up in this position, which is another funky position you can do.
Which leads us, straight to this lead right hand, follow left hand. Mm-hmm. So the main thing, one move we did here was pass by. Or pass by, so pass and follow by to the lead right. Which mimics our traditional pass by. The other move we did was basically an inside turn, but mirrored. So as a lead, you step on the way to the right hand side, and you make sure your arm is to the far side of the follow so that they don't turn underneath it.
Let's do it one more time just so they can see on this side. And then third set of connections.
Third set of connections was left to right. You get into here,
left to left,
left to left, left to left, all people's left hand. You get into here either by doing some sort of pass by and just connecting straight up there, or by getting into this right to left hand connection and then just switching your hands.
Sneaky, sneaky.
Sneaky, sneaky. We got two variations of a very similar turn. First of which is pretty much in place, where the lead rock step forward to set up this rotation, which is very important for the rest of it.
Yeah, and they're leading this way, kind of through my arm as a follow, and follows, I react to this by turning. So. Sorry. It's for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
You need to make sure, as a lead, you're close enough to them so that they can rotate under your arm, so your hands can be like, over, need to be over here at some point. And you keep your arm moving around them so that it doesn't interrupt their turning at all. And they stay balanced.
What was
the last move? Last move is very similar to that, but you're going to switch places. So instead of stepping in place, you're going to step backwards to get the stretch feeling. If they start moving toward you, you're going to move out of the way as a lead, and then you're going to keep your hand on this far side of them so that they don't turn on you.